Java powers 3 billion devices, but Go is eating its lunch in the cloud. One is the reliable veteran with decades of enterprise cred. The other is Google's speed demon built for the modern web. But which one should you actually use for your next backend? Let's find out in 240 seconds. Java dropped in 1995 and promised to write once, run anywhere. A revolutionary idea that helped it conquer enterprise backends worldwide. Fast forward to 2009. And Google engineers got tired of waiting for C++ to compile. So they built Go, a language designed for cloud native. And as you know, in the cloud era, memory is money. And here is where things get really interesting. A basic Java Spring Boot app needs about 300 megabytes just to say hello world. Meanwhile, Go can do the same with just 20 megabytes. Java's memory usage is like your friend who comes over and eats everything in your fridge. Go is like that polite guest who brings their own snacks. And as you know, in the container world, this is so important. More efficient services means more instances per machine, lower cloud bills, and happier DevOps. But everything aside, the real showdown happens when thousands of users hit your service at once. Java uses OS threads, which cost about 1 megabyte each. Go uses goroutine that start at just 2 kilobytes. This means a single Go server can handle thousands of concurrent connections without breaking a sweat, while Java needs complex concurrency patterns. But wait a second, Java finally realized it doesn't need a whole megabyte to say hello. In Java 21, virtual threads have arrived. They are lightweight like goroutines, starting at about 4 kilobytes each. So now, both Java and Go can effortlessly handle thousands of concurrent connections without complex thread pools or manual management. In real world, both have their own champions. Netflix, Amazon, and most financial institutions run on Java, while Uber, Twitch, and Docker are powered by Go. Netflix uses Java to recommend shows, while Twitch uses Go to show you people watching other people play games. But here is where it gets interesting. Uber moved their geofence service from Java to Go and saw latency drop by 70%. But guys, the reality is modern architectures often use both. Java excels at complex business logic and processing, while Go shines at network services and high-throughput APIs. So guys, in the end, it's not like Java or Go. It's Java and Go, like peanut butter and jelly, except one takes 10 times more memory. Smart teams choose the right tool for each job. So when should we choose Java? When you need a massive ecosystem of libraries. When your team already knows it and you're building complex enterprise application or long-term performance after warm-up is critical. And you should choose Go when deployment size and startup time. Really, this one is important. Startup time matters. You're building microservices or serverless functions. High concurrency is a requirement. You want simpler deployment with no runtime dependencies. The smart move isn't picking a side. It's knowing when to use each tool for the right job.